Hello, good afternoon. My name is Mukund Shenge. I am from Fronius, India. We are representing a premium inverter in string inverter technology. So our product portfolio is restricted to small commercial and industrial rooftop segment. So we are not catering to the multi-megawatt projects and central inverter category. Here there are few topics I just wanted to highlight. Since 2010, we have seen significant reduction in the project prices and the cost of levelized cost of electricity. This decrease from 20 crores to today 4.5 crores per megawatt is creating immense pressure on component manufacturer to reduce the cost. So this is in turn it is good for an industry to flourish. However, it is very important to know, what component suppliers have to do with the reliability and the quality of the product. So it's very important, this pressure is getting transferred to increase the capacities of the inverters to cope up with the required project prices and all. But end of the day, we have a lot of presentations today to understand the performance of the plant. For example, Vamanji also given a lot of presentations on how you track the performance levels of the particular plant. But we, as of now, do not have any analytical tool to understand failure of a particular performance level because of selection of wrong component in the project over the long term. For example, if you choose some wrong inverter instead of using reliable quality inverters, so what would be the impact of the generation? What could be the impact on the losses created by shedding? Of course, the derating is also important factor, because a lot of times to cope up the price requirements from the project, we have to do a lot of overloading, not from the technical point of view, but to compensate the project pricing, right? So all these things are resulting into somewhere somewhere it is not going good sense to give consider the long project life of 20 to 25 years for the end users, right? So we have to understand and consider what is important today to consider into the projects. So that's one thing, and apart from that, there's a regulation which is also giving a lot of emphasis on improving our grid standards. There's a distributed generation regulation from CEA 2012, and which is getting amended with newer clauses every year. However, it is very important to understand, if we are talking about interconnecting distributed generation plant to any industrial or commercial rooftop, what should be the quality of the grid, right? So this is often getting ignored, and lot of plants, even if they are performing well in developed countries, they're not able to perform in grid conditions like Indian grid conditions, for example. So that is also has to be addressed in long run. Yeah, and of course, one of the major performance criteria for inverters is also derating, apart from efficiency. So derating is something what is to protect inverters from higher temperature stresses. So it has been managed to reducing the output power of the inverter by triggering the current limit function, which is again a function of MPPT in the inverter. So we have different possibilities to look at the derating aspects of the particular inverter. For example, you can compensate the derating factor into efficiency measurement, or you can separately state it in your data sheet. There are two techniques actually, but at the end, it's very important. These kind of things are there to protect the inverter, and the core component has, and the architect of the inverter has to decide what approach he has to select. For example, he will not show derating and show the effect in the efficiency curve, or he separately shows the efficiency impact and derating impact and work on the firmware settings within the inverter. So these are the two things. Just wanted to be clear on this aspect. I just wanted to talk about these aspects, and thank you very much. Thanks.